A disaster we have all grown accustomed to. Just think of it, no generation on Earth has ever lived in peace. The scourge of war has claimed millions of lives, but it has also ruined the cultural legacy of humanity, destroying many masterpieces of art, the embodiment of wisdom and beauty. The 20th century was the most devastating one in the history of culture. Early in the 20th century, Russian painter Nicholas Roerich sought to break this vicious circle of self-destruction. He came up with the so-called Roerich Pact, an international agreement calling upon nations to promote peace through culture.
Эти идеи постепенно формулировались у него.
This concept didn't come to him overnight. He tried to create an environment that would enable us to think in new ways and eventually realize that the most beautiful things in life are shared by all the peoples of the world. Those beautiful things are art, historical monuments, and other parts of our common cultural heritage. The world is now divided into destroyers and creators. If one side urges us to bring down churches, museums, and the entire cultural heritage, if the dark forces call on destroying all Raphael's works, those who understand that humanity will only survive through spiritual values will have to speak a lot louder and stronger. Here, at the United Nations, few had expected such dark and evil forces to appear. It's not just a sectarian war they are fighting. These are the forces that target cultural heritage no less ferociously and furiously than those who have a different religion or a different worldview.
Now, these days, with the conflicts that we see all over the world, art, history, and common heritage are suffering a lot. Some of them will never be back to us because they'll be annulled completely. So it's a moment of reflection and of action so that this doesn't happen anymore.
The recent years have seen an alarming trend of increasing acts of vandalism against historical monuments. You have just recalled a number of incidents that took place in many countries of the world, something that causes grave concern. That's why Nicholas Roerich, his beliefs and ideas are so relevant today. These days, humanity needs to revisit Roerich's philosophical and spiritual legacy because, let me emphasize it, it is vital for global civilization.
Monuments and objects of art are depositories of fine matter and the fine energy that corresponds to it. They hold this fine energy. Whenever architectural works or pieces of art are burnt or otherwise destroyed because of war or or because of human ignorance. Our cosmic evolution suffers irreparable damage.
It has been 80 years since Nicholas Roerich first voiced his famous idea, but it remains relevant today, which means that the world, shaken by conflicts, plagued by misunderstanding and animosity, still needs peace and quiet. So I believe that Roerich's ideas indeed have a future. Nicholas Roerich was a visionary. Back in the 1930s, he predicted the future of humankind and the need for a concerted effort to protect monuments of art.
And his vision that culture and peace go together and that peace can be created through or can be arrived at through culture, I thought was a very important view that he took.
It's very important to protect cultural objects. By destroying them, we also destroy the ideas that underpin them and the people who created them.
Architectural monuments, amazing Gothic cathedrals, Russian churches with golden domes, beautiful old castles and palaces. They were created by individuals who initially perceived in their inner life the images of these cultural treasures. People that are capable of such creative work are connected to higher matter. The most prominent place among them belongs to artists and architects. Since they're capable of embodying these works of art that they perceived by an initial image, we can say that they participate in the creation of this subtle energy. Cultural treasures and beauty itself hold this energy. What is beauty, after all? Beauty is the origin of energy for the creative process. If there's no beauty, we lack the subtle energy needed for the evolution of humanity, the evolution of our planet Earth. Many people still fail to realize that culture is indeed the groundwork for our development and for our evolution.
Thank you.
I really don't know how to define those who destroy these monuments. The energy of the cultural objects perishes with their demolition. It just can't stay on in the air. When its matter is gone, the energy is also gone. And that's where the pact comes in. It seeks to protect more than the culture, so much more. That's a very narrow definition. It also seeks to protect our cosmic evolution. Culture must never be the victim. Culture is the foundation. It's the driving force of life. This is why the Roerich Pact is so pivotal. It's really so important.
Now, if we look back so many years, we still see that the message that was at that time so relevant is still relevant today, and that we have not yet found the answer to how to preserve cultural heritage and especially cultural objects that are of importance to the whole of the world, to all of mankind.
I can only hope for more people like Nicholas Roerich to be there with us and to provide their vision for society. This is the only way for us to see our dreams come true. He was definitely a pioneer, and the ecumenical movement recognizes his effort. This is why I value Nicholas Roerich so highly, as well as his idea of peace through culture. Roerich's message is very important. It should constitute one of the pillars in the upbringing of young people. This is a fundamental part of who we are. The Roerich Museum in Moscow now plays a leading role in spreading the word on the Roerich Pact and explaining its pacifist ideas to the world. Ever since the museum was founded a quarter of a century ago, this effort has been promoted by Roerich's younger son, Svyatoslav. Protecting cultural objects in times of war and peace is the first step on the way to universal peace. This is the message that underpins the museum's comprehensive activities in education. The museum has held international conferences on conservation of cultural heritage, issued dozens of books and hundreds of publications, and organized exhibitions dedicated to the pact across Europe, Asia, Latin America, the United States and Russia. Every year, Nicholas Roerich's ideas are gaining increasing attention from the international community, governments, the United Nations and UNESCO. In 2015, UNESCO Director General Irina Bokova visited the Roerich Museum in Moscow as a token of her profound respect for Nicholas Roerich, as well as the mission of the museum to internationally promote Roerich's pacifist idea of peace through culture.
Having a center, a park that preserves his ideas and what he promoted, we think it's a great contribution. And this is very much in line of the UN, which is the place that wants to preserve the past and build a better future.
I am very glad that I have had such an obligation as an organizer in cooperation with the International Center of the Roerichs in Moscow.
These actions teach us peace through preservation of culture. For the Church, the Roerich Pact and its ideas have an eternal importance. My opinion is that we must uphold the Center's efforts in promoting and explaining Nicholas Roerich's beliefs. I don't know who claims there is no need for them. The UN views the center's activities in this field as a positive development. Not only should we take every effort to protect our cultural heritage, which brings together the best achievements of humanity, but we must also value it very highly and remember how it elevates the human spirit every time we come into contact with it.